Harper Design and Harper Audio present It's All in Your Head. Get Out of Your Way by yours truly, Russ. I dedicate this book to you. Introduction. You are here. If you have a dream, read this book. If you're flipping through these pages, or rather listening to this, you probably have a little flame flickering, waiting for you to pour gas on it. Something you want to do, to be, to make. There's nothing that's impossible. Music is a lens through which I see the world. I express my truth through my music. Music, to me, is one of the most pure examples of a higher power. You can't touch music. It's a feeling. Music is the soul stripped away from the body in audio format. When you record music, you transcend your body. It's an example of manifesting, bringing something into existence using what's in your head. Making music teaches me so much about myself and the world, but it isn't music itself that teaches me, it's the pursuit of my greatest passion. Whatever that thing is that takes you to a higher level, that connects you to the best possible version of yourself, that helps you live purposefully, that's your passion. But my success actually has very little to do with the music. I'm simply a vessel that communicates my higher purpose. Connecting to your higher purpose is essential. All the tools I use to create my success in music are easily applicable to just about anything you're passionate about, whether it's starting a business or following an artistic calling or strengthening a community. But passion and self-belief are paramount to any endeavor. Your success is directly related to your self-belief. I couldn't even get to the point where I could make a song that y'all love if I was not mentally equipped to go through 10 years of sounding terrible. Sure, now the music sounds good, but that took years, not just of practice, but of delusional self-belief. It was a long process of anonymity, putting out songs that no one heard, and the whole time maintaining an unwavering belief that on any given day, I could wake up and discover that my music had blown up. There are three essential qualities required for turning your real life into your dream life: delusion, persistence, and gratitude. Delusion will give you faith when there is absolutely nothing in your present life that indicates you should believe. It is absolutely all in your head. Persistence will provide strength to keep going. Gratitude allows you to appreciate all that you have and the achievement of your goals, both small and large. What you think about, you bring about. The positive energy generated by your gratitude will yield more blessings. You will see that your dream will continually unfold. Get out of your way. As far back as I can remember, I've always had pure, undiluted confidence. I was confident in myself before I even knew myself. In high school, before I turned in a test, I'd write 100 at the top of every paper. Yeah, my teachers were not super fond of me. I was voted most likely to make a teacher retire, but I always made really good grades, so there wasn't too much that they could say. When I was 14, I started making beats. Although now I can tell you objectively that they were terrible, back then I thought they were the most amazing beats in the world. Even as a little kid, I was obsessed with being the best. At 5 years old, playing basketball with my brother, I was a veteran shit talker. I've always had this stain of confidence, even when I didn't really know what I was being confident in. So I've played soccer all of maybe 1.5 times in my entire life. The one time was in 8th grade, and it was just PE, and we're outside, and all the soccer kids who are in the class are, you know, playing a game of soccer. Me, being just obnoxious and super confident for no reason, whatever, I'm talking crazy shit to all these kids that play soccer. Keep in mind, I've never played soccer in my life, but I'm talking shit as if I'm the Kobe Bryant of soccer. That was just how I approached everything. There's some people who walk into situations or opportunities or wherever, and they think, I don't know how this is about to go. I'm not that great. Or there's some people who walk into those same situations and they're like, I'm going to kill this. I'm the best, et cetera, et cetera. That's a choice. It's on your head. But we won the soccer game 1-0. I scored the goal. And so I didn't let any of those soccer kids live that down until we graduated high school. I know it sounds nutty, but I genuinely believe with every ounce of my body that I've never failed. You could say putting out 11 projects and none of them blowing up was a failure, but I don't look at it like that. Where you see failure, I see stepping stones. To win, you need to get out of your own way. You decide whether to be your greatest obstacle or your biggest fan. The secret is being able to ride out the time between when you're the only one who believes that what is in your head is actually going to come to fruition in the moment when it actually does. That period is when everything can go left. It can make the most confident mind doubtful. That's where you lose. You don't lose to a competitor or to an industry or to a boss. You lose to yourself. Defeating your own self-doubt is the biggest obstacle to overcome. At 17, when my best friend Boogies and I started to navigate this musical journey, we equipped ourselves mentally. Besides being each other's biggest fans and best sounding boards, we also educated each other. We acquired a small arsenal of books that empowered us to stay positive, to build immunity to self-doubt, and to weather the years of waiting for the rest of the world to recognize what we already knew. I was never a big reader, which is why this whole venture is kind of hilarious to my family, especially to my brother Frank, who seems to read a different book every day. But the books that I did read were instrumental in arming me with the mental artillery to succeed. I wanted to read them because they offered me something I could use. That's what I want this book to be for you, something you can use. My confidence or cockiness, whatever you want to call it, isn't fueled by a sense of superiority and it isn't based on my success. Yes, I believe I'm great, but I believed that when I was a kid making shitty music in my basement. That's how I got to where I am today. I'm successful because I'm confident. I'm not confident because I'm successful. I want you to understand that I'm not shit, truly. But the fact is that I always believed I was the shit, and that's the trick. Look at me and think, if he believes in himself, then I can believe in myself, because who the fuck is he? Look at me and know that you can absolutely do it. You can instill that insane confidence in yourself and get wherever it is you want to be. All my confidence and success should do is make you feel like you can be great too. After 11 albums, 96 singles, and I'm probably missing a few, and 10 years of sitting in a basement, literally and figuratively, I finally made it to the proverbial penthouse. Some of you might feel trapped in the basement. Some of you might be stuck on the third floor. Some of you might not even realize you're in an elevator. What I've laid out in these pages and in this little recording are tools you can use to fix your own elevator, or at least help you see that you are, in fact, in an elevator, and then we can both celebrate in the penthouse and shoot through the ceiling of the whole place because there is no fucking ceiling. It's all in your head. Got me so glad I know myself. Part 1. Delusion. Chapter 1. Manifest. Speak your goals into existence. Your thoughts hold weight in the universe. A long time ago, this woman told me, you have to be careful what you think about because it comes true. You can think things into existence. You can speak things into existence. You can believe things into existence. That's manifesting. Music is an intangible embodiment of ideas that can permeate a room in this beautiful harmony of emotion and sound. It can fill space and enter bodies and minds. It can transport people. My body's certainly not in the room while you're listening to this, or my songs, and yet I am. Making music is a kind of manifesting. To make music, you take nothing and turn it into something. When you walk into a studio, it's dead quiet. There's nothing going on. There aren't any chords, there's no drums, yet with your imagination, your work, and your belief, you can have a song that changes the whole world.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.